Hello friends, hope you're having a great time with your family, and today we start with an attempt to find an answer. Is SpaceX going to be the destination for all of Europe? Let's get into the recent space industry, where several European spacecrafts are heading towards SpaceX rockets for launch. For quite a long time, SpaceX occasionally launched spacecraft developed in Europe or by European companies, but recently such types of launches are coming in large numbers. And as per sources, it's expected that this scenario will continue to increase till the rest of the year. The present Russia-Ukraine conflict situation, and as well as delays in development of Ariane Space's next-gen Ariane 6 rocket, had ultimately pushed many of the European satellites to the SpaceX rockets for launch. Recently, on the 15th of October 2022, a Falcon 9 rocket launched from the Hotbird 13F communication satellite into a geostationary transfer orbit for Eutelsat, a French SATCOM company. With this launch, SpaceX started a series of European launches on their rockets. According to reports, Hotbird 13F is the first of three Eutelsat satellites that they'd planned to launch on SpaceX rockets. After the launch was carried out, another satellite, Hotbird 13G, arrived in Florida in a custom Airbus Beluga XL transport jet. Earlier on the 12th of October, another satellite, Eutelsat 10B, was shipped from France on an ocean-going Ariane space ship for its journey towards Florida. Sources state that both these satellites will be launched atop Falcon 9 by the beginning of November. Hotbird 13F, Hotbird 13G, and Eutelsat 10B were scheduled to launch on Ariane space rockets. Eutelsat 10B on Ariane 5 rocket, and Hotbird 13F and 13G on Ariane 6 rocket. Delays in the date of the launch debut of Ariane 6 from late 2022 to mid-2023 had ultimately urged Hotbird satellites to shift from Ariane 6 to Falcon 9 rockets. But it's quite surprising that the most used Ariane 5 wasn't able to launch Eutelsat 10B, and it had to turn to SpaceX for launch. Other than Eutelsat spacecraft, many other satellites had turned to SpaceX. Most recently, the joint NASA-ESA-CSA Surface Water and Ocean Topography (SWOT) spacecraft was transported from France to California on October 17. Reports say that SWOT will launch atop Falcon 9 from the California coast by as early as December this year. As per sources, Germany's second and third SARA radar satellites could head for launches atop a Falcon 9 in late 2022 or early 2023. According to a NASA official, the European Space Agency is now trying to find out whether they could launch their next-generation Euclid space telescope on SpaceX's Falcon 9. Earlier, it was scheduled to launch on one of Ariane Space's Russian-built Soyuz 2.1 rockets or Ariane 6 rockets in mid-2022. But the Russian invasion of Ukraine in early 2022 doomed the use of Soyuz 2.1 rockets. Ariane 6 delay in launch debut has also made it a not suitable option for Euclid, so there are high chances that ESA will select SpaceX for the launch. Another European company, OneWeb, had a contract with Russia to launch all of their Internet Constellation satellites in a series of 21 Soyuz launches. But after the Ukraine invasion, Russia captured a batch of OneWeb satellites and also requisitioned a Soyuz rocket that OneWeb had already purchased. This halted the launch of OneWeb Constellation, and they lost almost $230 million. As per reports, the initial launches of OneWeb will now be carried out on an Indian SLV-3 rocket, and later they'll fly on SpaceX rockets. iSpace's Hakuto-R moon lander, which was largely assembled, tested, and propelled by France's Ariane Group, will also be launched on a SpaceX rocket. While SpaceX is becoming the destination for European space companies, Elon Musk had recently forewarned about possible delays in preparing Starship for commercial flights. SpaceX has almost pioneered the reusable rocket systems with their Falcon 9 rocket. Moreover, their pace of progression and development in interplanetary Starship vehicles is going on very well. But still, problems come in every big and great work, and recently Musk had warned about some possible problems that may create any delay in the development of Starship rocket. in turn pushing back the commercial private flights. On the 16th of October, Sunday, Chris Gebhardt, assistant managing editor of the NASA spaceflight website, wrote to Musk, "With a full-stack Starship on the pad at Starbase, testing is set to get moving this week as SpaceX aims to put a full load of methane and oxygen into Booster 7 and Ship 24 for the first time. Then, static fire time." Musk replied that, "We are proceeding very carefully. If there's a RUD on the pad, Starship progress will be set back by 6 months." According to sources, the term RUD, or Rapid Unscheduled Disassembly, is used by Musk to refer to any explosion during Starship tests. From Musk's tweet, it's clear that he's giving probable warnings of delays in Starship development if the upcoming tests ends in explosion. And if any such thing happens, it'll lead to a 6-month gap before SpaceX teams can again gear up for another test after necessary repairs. Just a few days back, billionaire Dennis Tito had booked a seat for a trip around the moon. Earlier, two other private Starship flights have been purchased by billionaires, Jared Isaacman and Yusaku Maezawa. As per sources, any delays in present Starship progress will have a good impact on these commercial missions. After these interesting updates, we'll now look at some recent Starlink updates before we wrap up for the day. The tech tycoon Elon Musk revealed that SpaceX has withdrawn its funding request to the Pentagon to start covering the cost of satellite internet service Starlink for Ukraine. Musk's statement was in response to a CNN exclusive that claimed SpaceX had sent a request to the Pentagon in September stating they were no longer able to supply the necessary Starlink terminals or fund the pricey auxiliary service for an indefinite length of time. According to CNN, SpaceX requested funding from the Pentagon to start providing services for the terminals already run by the Ukrainian government, as well as to build over 8,000 new terminals and provide new services for Ukraine's military and intelligence agencies. Following the publication of the request and more thorough evidence that SpaceX is not solely to blame for Starlink connectivity in Ukraine, Musk tweeted, "To hell with it. Even though Starlink is still losing money and other companies are getting billions of taxpayer dollars, we'll just keep funding the Ukraine government for free." This week, Musk tweeted that the request to the Defense Department had been rescinded, according to the report. The tweet went a little further. According to two sources briefed on the discussions between SpaceX and the Pentagon had actually granted SpaceX's request to pay for ongoing service for the Ukrainian government as of Friday, prior to Musk's apparent about-face. The Pentagon also granted the new request from the commanding general of Ukraine. For the balance of 2022, $124 million in funds was asked for. What was ultimately agreed upon in terms of both money and terms is unclear. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.